recent times, Keith Shebada Ramsey has been weighing in on a wide cross-section of topical issues, begging the question, is the bashment granny actor a social commentator now?
Hey, Facebook.
Shebada will be here to answer, as well as unveil a new project.
When you go get ready, me I carry the home.
Clear! Cemetery!
Marking his 10th anniversary in theater.
Boom shalazum gashman.
Is Devin Di Dakta the next Grammy Kid?
Yeah.
He's only one step away, believe it or not.
Ready now, now.
And will be here.
Personally.
Despite his success in music.
Up and down now.
Is Kalado battling depression?
Me, maim and sorrow.
And the Jamaican vlogger with the biggest following on social media.
If you're ugly and you know it, clap your hands.
Tells how he's exploiting this incredible popularity.
Don't want your eyes on me.
This week's E! News reviews and more, all coming up. Welcome to the show, everyone. I am Winford Williams. We'll be back.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
And we're back with the stories making our E! News and reviews this week.
They don't love you like I love you.
The Grammy nominations for the year 2016 have been announced, and Beyoncé leads the pack with a whopping 9 nominations for her multi-platinum album, Lemonade. On the Jamaican front, Sean Paul copped 2 nominations for his number one single with Sia, Cheap Thrills, in the Best Pop Duo or Group category and Best Producer, while Drake's dancehall-laced Views and Rihanna's Work have multiple nominations. Not to be left out is Major Lazer with a nom for Best Producer for Cold Water with Justin Bieber. The reggae album category is shared this time around by Jamaicans and Americans 50-50, with nominations for Ziggy Marley, Raging Fire, and a joint album from JL and Devin Di Dakta, while J Boog, Revolution, and Soulja represent the United States of America. More on the reggae album Grammy with Devin Di Dakta later in this show. The 59th Grammy Awards is set for Sunday, February 12, 2017. The silly season is just around the corner, and the island is abuzz with activities all around. Some important events you might have missed are the inaugural staging of the One World Ska and Rocksteady Music Festival on Saturday, November 26, at the Randy Williams Entertainment Center, which, despite the low turnout, delivered amazing performances by all the build acts.
We have set a pattern that we can build on for next year and on ensuing years.
And on Friday, December 2nd, as part of Kingston Music Week, Third World and Family, like Chronix, Toots, Fred McGregor, Tony Rebel, and more, went under the stars to benefit Children First Jamaica, an organization providing life-changing programs for children and adolescents.
Well, I grew up in a place called Elevator.
Some of the same names just mentioned, plus the Marley Brothers, performed at a Smile Jamaica concert on Saturday at the Bob Marley Museum, marking the 40th anniversary of the Smile Jamaica concert, held by Bob Marley and the Wailers at the National Heroes Park in Kingston on December 5, 1976, just 2 days after an assassination attempt on the gong.
50 feel good.
Richie Stevens has hit the milestone of 50 years on the earth, and on Monday night at his home in Kingston, took the time to celebrate that, plus his major achievements in ska and ska tech, with the release of a 15-minute documentary, which is available on YouTube. And speaking of documentary, hundreds came out for a special premiere of Usain Bolt's I Am Bolt.
For his height, they said he shouldn't be running so fast.
On Tuesday night at the National Indoor Sports Center, a piece of work that encapsulates the sprinter's tough and emotional journey to greatness.
Our body really showed me a lot of love, I mean, getting our support, a lot of good feedback, so that's a good thing. And people have said it's been really emotional, and they're happy they saw the way I was, and they saw inside of my life, so that's what I wanted to get across. I'm happy about it.
Are you ready?
All right, so those are the stories making our E! News and reviews for this week. But stick it right here on stage, still to come. Shebada turns 10. But what's his fascination with social commentary. Devin Di Dakta, the next Grammy Kid, Kalado Suicidal, Trabass's latest move to exploit his social media popularity, all coming up right here on our stage. We'll be right back.
Put some respect on my name now. Put some respect on my name. Put some respect on my name now.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. In the Jamaican music industry, one thing that is often overlooked is the well-being of the artists themselves. Exhaustion, drug abuse, and depression are just some of the unfortunate and serious realities of the music industry, not just here in Jamaica, but globally. Our guest in this segment is one example of an artist who knows about the effects of depression, both on a personal level and through his now deceased friend, Delos. Kalado is who we are talking about right now on our stage. Kalado, sir.
Welcome in.
Good to see you. Good to see your smile, sir. So what can you tell us about what you're faced with right now?
Well, you know, it's just it's an interview I did. They say they're always hearing the bad things pop up in the news, and you know, when I know he's a situation or, you know, assault business or...
So you did an interview? Or,
yeah.
Forgive me for asking you all these questions, because I am not aware of that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. So, okay. So you did an interview.
Yeah.
And in that interview...
Yeah, what?
The conclusion was drawn, or could be drawn, that you are facing some...
Yeah,
issues.
Yeah, depression, like, you know.
So are you or not?
Yeah, of course. I show them what channel, you know, took you through that depression, you understand?
Okay.
It's, you know, after, you know, in the music thing, you know, the pressure and the hardship of working, see? But it's still in your life, different from the music also. So I show them, say, for example, imagine Winford. Me as a youth coming from with appearance, with less support, I should say. You got me, I say? Then from school, went up, then when you're not knowing your mother and your father, really, and then you go to a situation where you, when you just know your father, him throw you out of the house, and then you live on the street, cold concrete for years, and you fight away and find yourself on a plane, and you understand? And then, like, the plane crashed, but not literally. And you get to me, I say, you're in a situation where, you know, you're traveling, me kind of slow down on that side of the U.S., then, you know,
yeah,
you see your friend disappear.
Visa issues.
Yeah, you know, and then you see your friend disappear. And
Delos disappear.
No, so, not just Delos. I'm talking about, like, friends around you. The support and things, they move on because of they feel you can't give them a dumpling in a them pot again.
Oh, so your friends kind of pull away from you.
Yeah, you know?
So all of these things combined
were
too much to bear.
And a lot more. It was just a definition. When they ask why, and I'm telling them that, you know, when I go through that depression, because everybody have suicidal thoughts, Winford. See? Look at the baller in Germany, you know?
Do you think so? That's a big statement,
Jamaica. The goalkeeper, you know, the goalkeeper in Germany will jump off of the train. It's depression.
Yes.
You understand?
No, anybody can be caught with it. Anybody can be depressed.
Yeah.
It's a mental disorder. But I'm saying, and yes, if you're saying that, anybody can be afflicted with it.
Exactly.
I will agree. But if, you know, but anyway, we're not debating that. What I'm saying, what is most important is where are you now in your mind? How do you feel right now?
Well, I'm feeling like, you know, either I go through a dark tunnel,
yes,
a phase, and then, like, you know, maybe you start to look a light.
Okay. So you're seeing some light now?
Yeah, you're seeing a light, like, you can push through, you know?
Did you seek professional counseling or anything like that?
At that time?
Yes.
No,
or
no,
since?
No, it's just since, you know, like, you know, counselors calling my phone and, you know, we in the process, you understand? But at that time, no, we just... thinking about, you know, the work and still, because you have to maintain life span and all the aspect same way, you know. Mm-hmm. Isn't it? Regardless of the hardship, you still have to clean up the, you know, the mess and push on.
Yes. Well, I hope you will seek professional advice and don't just say, you know, I'm good, or because you're feeling better now that you, because there's always something new to learn. And maybe they will help you to they will put in your consciousness and in your cranium ways to deal with issues when they arrive. Because sometimes we can survive these things. Sometimes these things we are bigger than and can go beyond and can even laugh at some of these hurdles in a future time. All we need to do is to get past this moment, or, you know what I mean? But the professionals, I don't discount the importance of those who do this. Because people tend to stigmatize. I want to commend you for coming forward and talking about it. Because people tend to stigmatize these things as mental illness, as madness.
Not for me,
stigmatize
it. It's just a fear, you know. You know what people message me, thousands of people messaging me say, they went through the same thing and they can relate.
Right, so because you went public, so you're not getting these things to show, you say, you're not alone.
So me end up
only because you went public.
For the people, only because I'm in the public.
Right, because you went public with it. Now, some people don't go public.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's exactly why some, unfortunately, have taken themselves out. So it's important to talk about things to people. And because there's always those who have the similar, even the same experience. So we commend you for coming forward. So so where are you now in terms of career?
You know, respect for my name, you know. You can see a bright way of feet and they don't know bounce and a sex slave. And if you're going to parties right now, when them song they drop crazy, you know, all snow start falling at Jamaica.
When them thing they drop.
When them thing they drop,
Well, there you go. There are these things now that you have in your brand. As part of your brand and a catalog that you're building.
I'm building a catalog and you know.
And it takes time to do this.
It takes a whole
lot of work. And even one you get a year, one tune, even though a moderate hit.
If you keep you going.
If you keep you going, even in that space, them pull you up now and then. That's enough. You're young. There's so much more that you will do. If you do one a year, in 10 years, you have 10 hits. 10 hits are enough to give you a life in music for the rest of your life. All right, so can we go to a tune for you? Can we jump a tune for you?
Yeah, man, definitely.
Let's do it.
When money come in your head, haters be hating. When money come in your head, evil come in your head. When money come in your head, haters be hating. Money pile up, if you mind but I know my luck. Never see when me a go for an a suffer. Once you over this a heart twist and it a boil up.
All right, so there you have it. This one from Kalado. Money comes evil. So explain that for us. The
you
title.
Know, you know, it explain, you know, when time, money, when success come, you know, you have all kind of evil and critiques and bad mind and all kind of things. And don't know how you work hard for your
things.
Evil.
Money attracts evil.
Pull
them in. It's like an evil magnet.
Because it's come like, you know, them say success of many parents and failure is an orphan child. So, you know, with money comes evil. Yeah, man, and look out for that one that's produced by Hitmaker Music, you know.
So there's a burial thing going on in the videos. Explain that.
Well, it's just that in the video I show you where I buried the old Kalado. And rebirth the new one.
Oh, so it's a burial of the old
Kalado.
Okay.
Into a new Kalado.
Could we apply that to life?
So I bury the past.
Yes.
You know?
And moving into a new
And
term,
moving on to a new space.
Understood.
Yeah. You know?
So who are we looking at now? The new you or are you still in the,
you know,
the transition?
I'm in the transition.
You're
over
that,
to the new one right
to
now.
To the new one right now.
Yeah, man.
So there's a new day dawning as far as you're concerned. Career-wise and as a person.
Exactly, you know?
Ah. What good answer. Yeah, so good to come and share with us.
Yeah, man.
And
yeah.
I hope we out yours, our listeners.
And you know, for those who don't know, they can check out on my face for my official page for the bookings right now. You understand? Because we change up certain things and in the process of now signing to building block managed by Carl. You understand? So if you go on official Kalado Instagram, you will see the information. It changed now. You get what I'm saying?
Oh, good. Nice. Well, youth, celebrate life. Thanks again for coming and sharing
Exactly.
All right, there you have him. Go support his music, Kalado. Our very special guest in this segment. Stay with us, still to come right here on stage. Shebada turns 10, but what's his fascination with social commentary? Trabass's latest move to exploit his social media popularity. And Devin Di Dakta, the next Grammy Kid, all coming up. We'll be back.
Baby, you are the one. Ready now, girl, you're so fine.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. When it comes to Jamaican social media stars, there isn't one that has capitalized on the new media more than the Florida-based guest in this segment. With almost 2 million followers across various platforms, the Jamaican comedian is the front runner and has used this popularity to venture into filmmaking.
It's the police, open up!
And music.
Higher than I ever been before, me go some places where some artists never tour.
His name is Andrew Trabass, and he's on the island for the first time since becoming the sensation he is today. And is inviting fans to come out and celebrate with him.
December 11, Waves Beach out of Portmore, I'm at take.
And Trabass, our very special guest right now, right here on stage. Trabass, sir, so good to have you.
Thanks for having me.
And it's surprising to hear that it's the first time since you've become this big star that you are.
Yeah.
That you're visiting Jamaica.
Yeah.
How so?
All right, my paperwork got caught up in some...
Okay, paperwork.
Yeah.
I see. Travel documents.
Yeah.
Is the reason.
Yeah.
Okay, it couldn't be that you just say, why? Yeah, because aren't you a product of Jamaica?
Definitely.
Born and bred?
Definitely. I've been away 8 years now.
Just 8 years.
Overseas, yeah.
Just 8.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're born and bred Jamaican. From where? From where in Jamaica?
Fletcher's Land.
Fletcher's Land.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then spend most of my summer holidays in Portland, Hector's River.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you migrated to the US. How?
It was all because of the war thing that was happening in Jamaica at the time with Dodos.
Okay.
Mommy and Daddy just said, time to go. It worked out good because I'm here on stage right now.
I know, you were a big star.
Yeah.
Anyway, so how did you get started?
Well, at first, normally my mom used to push me to get work and all of that. She seen I love doing videos, so she pushed me to like make videos for people. And I was like, why not put myself out? Why not be a commentator or make videos, like comedy videos? So I tried it. It worked. I got a lot of fans from it. From the first try, I tried it. People requested more, and I started doing more. And now my name, Trabass, built as a brand.
Yes.
So the comedy thing was really the thing that put me out there.
Yes.
To the world, yeah.
So which piece of your work would you say that was the one that break you out, that gave you the breakout?
It's a lot, to be honest. It's a lot, though.
There wasn't the first one where this
It was the
went
first
wild.
One with my dog.
Yes.
When I was back home in Jamaica, my dog, I post that video, it went viral. Then people start looking up my name and say I do more stuff. I do comedy, actually, talking about relationships and all of that.
Okay.
Yeah, so I got a fan, like a huge fan base from everywhere start watching me because at the time, nobody in the Caribbean really wasn't doing videos like how I was doing it. And from that, people just take a liking to me.
Yes.
Yeah.
So who are your fans? Are they just Caribbeans?
Or? No. It's so crazy. My fans are Africa, all over the world. Like, almost all over the world. I met this guy in the mall the other day. He was from Europe. He was talking to me and I was like, I was shocked because I was like, I'm over there. He was like, you're big over there. Like, if you're supposed to come over there, it's crazy. I was like, okay.
So, them love the Jamaican chat, the Jamaican lingua.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're raw, straight Jamaican, aren't you? You're not pretending to be anybody else.
Nah, not pretend. I stick to my roots. I grew up back in our culture, like when Bounty Killer Beanie Man did I take the place. Mm. At that time, was my era where I stick to and I love. That's why you see my haircut like this with the back stuff and all that. I'm into that. Like,
that's a 90s in a youngster.
Yeah.
Your genre is comedic vlogger. Would you consider
just say that? Entertainer overall.
Entertainer overall. Because you make up appearances at shows and so on.
Yeah, I perform. I perform songs and
what have you.
Yeah, meet and greet, all of that. My true fans know this. Like, working hard for reach here right now talking to you is a main big thing to me. Like, there's no shortcut in being famous. You have to put in the work. And that's what I'm doing.
It only look glamorous on screen, right?
Yeah, but behind it, hard work, sleepless nights. Mm-hmm. It's a lot.
So, did you do any formal training in any of these things?
No, to be honest, I learned everything on my own. Mm-hmm. Well, from YouTube, because YouTube is like a teacher itself.
Absolutely, yeah.
So when I'm home and have free time, I just look up certain things, like how to do this, how to do that. Mm-hmm. And now I could edit, I could do everything you could think of.
And how far did you go in school as a kid, as a youngster?
Big up St. Andrew Technical, I graduated. Mm-hmm. It was good, micro practice in primary and junior high. Mm-hmm. I wasn't doing real good in school, and my mom know that. My mom and dad know that. So I think this was my calling.
Like, and they're proud of you now, right?
Very, very, very. I seen my mom the day before yesterday, as I came off the plane. Yes. Hugged her and cried. It was emotional.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Before I left, I promised her I would be on stage. And I'm here right now.
Oh, wow. What a good thing we were able to have you, because I would feel bad if we didn't get to talk to you. Because we've always wanted to have you on our show, because we really respect and are encouraged and ourselves motivated by your achievement.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure hearing
And many of your fans are ours, too, so because we go for the diaspora. You know what I mean? But there's an event. You're calling out fans to celebrate with you.
So. Yes, for my birthday party, my 27th birthday party. Mm-hmm. It's going to be crazy.
And that's when?
December 11th. This Sunday coming.
Sunday coming,
Waves where? Beach, Portmore.
So it's this Sunday, tomorrow Sunday, where?
Waves Beach, Portmore.
And it will take what form? Who is there? Any big star? What?
Well, I'm going to give you the name of the host that's going to be there. Ding Dong, my brother Lincoln Chidat, and Danny Boo. Apart from that, surprise guest artist. It's going to be crazy. Just imagine, first time coming in to Jamaica, 8 years.
Yeah.
I have a lot in store for my fans.
And you will definitely be performing.
Yeah, definitely.
Sure.
All my songs that my fans love, I would be doing it. So I just dropped my EP yesterday. Tribulation consists of 8 tracks. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. And I have a new single out now on YouTube, Get High, featuring me and El Capitan, my producer. Mm-hmm. It's out, and the views going up on it. I think it's going to be a hit.
So is your own family? You have a family yet, for yourself?
My wife.
You're married?
Yeah, love her.
Legally married?
Yeah.
And children?
No children.
No children yet. You're hunting, though.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Good for you, sir. Congrats, man.
Thanks.
Thank you so much for coming, Trabass. It's so good to have you right here on our stage.
Yeah.
And we're looking forward to the party.
Yeah.
Okay? At Waves Beach.
Yes, this Sunday.
This Sunday.
Starting from 2 p.m. till 10 p.m.
Waves Beach in Portmore. Trabass. All right, so there you have him right here on stage, our very special guest in this segment, Trabass. Stay with us, still to come. Shebada, and later, the next Grammy Kid.
From the first time I see ya, I see ya, I see ya.
Grammy see ya.
Hey, ya, me need ya, me need ya, me need ya.
Need you.
The first time I see ya, I see ya, I see ya.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. Since the last time, actor-comedian Keith Shebada Ramsey was here, he has added social commentary to his portfolio, weighing in or at least sharing some of the most topical issues in Jamaican life, spanning the spectrum of crime, politics, dancehall, and more. Shebada, who is celebrating 10 years in theater with the launch of a brand new project, is our guest right now, right here on stage. Shebada, sir, welcome. Yeah. Good to have you back. So you've rebranded yourself as social activist, stroke, commentator?
I don't think I'm rebranding.
You've always been?
I've always been.
Yes?
Yes.
But you've turned it up in recent time or what?
Because I have access to the internet now. But okay. First time I didn't.
So you were always weighing in on these things?
Right,
how,
always.
How were you doing it?
In a small forum. You understand, but since the internet is so, social media is so widespread, yes, that is why persons believe that I am just speaking out now, but I've always been talking about this stuff.
Okay, and you're an activist too, or just commentating?
I'm just a commentator. Yeah, I don't think I'm an activist yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
Okay, so what are some of the issues that you're most concerned about?
The living condition as it relates to some Jamaican folks, you understand me, and the hypocrisy in dancehall as it relates to some dancers and selectors in dancehall, you understand?
And what are some of these?
I don't want to say much now. Mm-hmm. No, I don't want to say you.
No, but come on, but you're in social media talking a lot.
All right. You know the thing about homosexuality. I'm not against or for. You understand me? But however, if you're going to speak on that, speak firmly and honestly. That is my concern.
So some of what people are talking about, you know otherwise. That's why you're saying that.
Yes.
And okay. So what are some of the contradictions, the specific
contradictions? No, I'm not here to talk about that, really. I'm here to talk about my 10 years.
Your 10 years in theater. Yeah, we're going to get there. Don't worry. We have time for you. Okay, so crime is another one that you've been talking a lot about.
Crime. I think Jamaica is a blessed country. We are one of the countries which have the most churches. You understand me? But yet, disasters, we hardly get them. Because the Lord knows how we can damage ourselves. Look at Mobile, look at Sivali, look at Rima. You understand what I'm saying? After Matthew, before Matthew.
Yes.
You understand? Matthew didn't come. But might as well him did come, because look at what is happening now.
Yes.
So, and how can we quell that? Or if it's inevitable, how can we alleviate it? Or, you understand me?
So, and you're part of the crime-free Christmas movement, are
yes,
you?
Yes, I want to be a part of that.
Okay. What about politics now? Let's talk a little bit of politics.
No, I can't speak about politics. I don't know nothing about politics. I try to stay far from
it. No, but there have been some big changes since you came here last in politics. The government changed.
The government changed, but the situation is still the same. It has been happening over and over. So it can't be like the government changed because the government changed. You understand? It's some things.
So you don't expect to see any changes?
No changes now going on.
What about the change of leadership in the PNP?
I don't know. Everybody, 6 and 1/2 dozen other. It's one basket, them shop at the same market. So
it don't mean nothing to you?
It don't mean nothing to me. Too bad if it mean anything to anybody else, so be it. But for me, I grew until now, grandma vote, grandpa vote, auntie vote, sisters vote. What them accomplish? Nothing.
Is what you're saying applicable to people from your community?
Yes, definitely so.
Most people feel the same way like you?
I don't know if they feel the same way as me, but based on persons who I speak to around the community, yeah, some of them share the same thing. But you know, as election come on and then bring the creator Guinness, come give them drop back again and start vote.
And the recent elections? The
same thing.
Local
government election, then beg me for come vote. I said, I don't vote, because it doesn't mean nothing to me. It is meaningless.
Okay, so you weren't surprised about the turnout?
No.
Or the result?
You know, so I'm not surprised about who win or who lose. I'm not surprised. When I tell you, them something, you know, no bother me at all. It just no bother me. It no faze me. It no move me. I'm not surprised. I'm not flabbergasted about anything at all that goes on in politics, because it's politics. So it can't surprise me.
Okay. All right. Let's talk a little bit more about dancehall before we go, because there's some big developments in the space in recent time. And we want to talk about, for example, cartel movement and those things, because you're as a social commentator,
let me talk
on
about
your read
cartel. And
yes.
Let me talk about that. I'm not a big enough friend. I'm not a buddy, look no friend or whatever. It is not a friendship thing here. I mean, the man is incarcerated, and you know him have him family for take care, but yet still, him a, let me just say, hide and do music. My problem is, if it had been a listener a citizen, a resident, you know, an ordinary Jamaican who talk about cartel, nothing a jail, I do music same way, a prison, I do music same way, I wouldn't have a problem with that. But when artists attack like that, it shows a level of bad mind. And remember that they are in the business.
Yes.
And tomorrow, today for cartel, tomorrow for them. I am disgruntled of the fact that you have Lexus and Flex talking about them not in cartel, should I in a jail, in a prison, I do music. I am disgruntled about that.
Okay.
I am very much perturbed about that. Because me, I say, how if I say a thing like that, and the world are not artists, you understand? Everybody make mistakes. You know, because you're not going out there as an artist and a man this year, who know what you're going to do? And try to cover it up. But when you go in a jail now, a prison, you still going to want to promote yourself. So when you speak like that as an artist, I just feel you say it unfair and very hypocritical and wicked. It's very pernicious. I may not take back nothing what I'm saying.
Okay. Sting. Talk about Sting. They may be, they're struggling to put on Sting this year. I don't even know what's going to happen.
Them for just to let out cartel for the night there. They're not for struggle.
You think that cartel could fix the whole thing?
Yeah.
If there's a show with him.
Let us face it.
Yes.
I mean, you have artists out there and they are good, but who really have the crowd going?
Papi.
Sorry?
Alkaline.
Okay.
Mavado.
I mean, you say Kevin Downs well, I know.
Kevin too, yes, of course.
Right, because
Kevin
might as well then put him alone for his thing, because a lot of what you call the music are just the same. The music, they are just the same.
Yes, so you would prefer a
I mean,
Kevin Downs.
I'm not going to lie, I feel say if them can't release cartel, put Kevin Downs well. Our Spice, the two of them, back to back.
Spice, you have to Lady Saw. Well, you don't say Kevin and Lady Saw.
Lady Saw be lighting now, man. She be lighting. You know,
yeah, give her a break.
Yeah, give her a little time for just come out.
Be lighting, yeah. in gospel.
Yeah.
But Kevin ready for take it?
Kevin ready and Lady Saw and Spice ready, cartel ready.
But come to think, it's not a bad idea, you know.
It's not a bad idea.
First thing to have looked.
Because we're looking at the answer,
look
now,
to the
honestly,
Lord.
Conscience come out with one album and it's shot. Where's the other album?
Yes.
You understand me? I mean, Jamaicans are too talented to be popcorn. I mean, not the artist, no. Popcorn like your pop, no.
Puppy,
I mean, the
popcorn.
Songs are good to listen to, like to play on the radio, to go on stage show. But for Sting, which is a big platform, I don't think that you need... Sting just needs something, man. Sting needs a ninja man and a shabarangs. It needs something. Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go to your 10 years. You're
because my 10 years are struggling me too, you know.
Shebada, the character, is celebrating 10.
Yeah.
And Keith Ramsey, the actor,
is celebrating 10 also.
Celebrating 10.
So put them together, I'm 20.
You're 20, okay. All right, so we're looking back at your accomplishment. How would you sum it all up? What's your legacy so far?
Legacy, I don't know about my legacy. You make me sound like Oliver Samuel.
No, you're not going nowhere.
You're
10 years is quite a milestone in anything.
It's funny because it's like quint, it come quick. I mean, I've grown, yes, and my growth is of some purpose in the sense that, you know, I'm widespread. I can proudly say that. You know, to my surprise, many persons know me. Growing up, and you know, before you get the little bus, you want the fame and you want the popularity. Because you know, sometimes you know, bus, you see artists and you say, Jesus, how them feel? You know, and all of that. I mean, yes, I got that, but it is not all mushy-mushy. Mm-hmm. It is not. It is hard work and perseverance and long-suffering.
Suffering?
Yeah.
What's the suffering?
Long
financial?
I mean, you have your ups and downs, your financial too. You understand me? You have freedom. That is one of the major things, freedom. You know, you can't go places. You can't be you, because persons expect you to be somebody else, what they see on stage. And that is not you off stage. You know, you're completely different. Mm-hmm. But persons won't get that.
Okay. Aren't you branded Bashment Granny and a roots theater actor? Wouldn't you say that?
I am not a roots theater actor.
You don't consider it?
No.
But aren't because you somewhat branded that way?
Yes.
Are you shedding it?
I'm not shedding it. I just want to correct it. Because we are Jamaicans. So if whatever other theater companies in Jamaica, whatever plays a function and put on, and you match it with mine, we are both roots theater. You understand me? Because roots come from your culture. Your culture roots. unless they are not Jamaicans. Mm. Them come from America and they display something. You understand me? I sell we for the American culture. No. The whole we go up on stage, the Oliver, the Miss Lou, everybody who go up on stage, they're my roots, theatre actor.
Okay. So you're not walking away from it, and it's as good as any other, you're saying?
It is good, and it's even better than some of them. Mm-hmm. Trust and believe.
All right, so you're doing this, you're marking your 10th anniversary with the Chicksters. Release of a brand new play. Talk about it.
Chicksters. It's about a mother and two daughters trying to con a man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I...
Are you the man? You're not the man, are you?
Look for me.
You couldn't be the man?
Me look like the man.
Well,
so.
Well, we know you to be a male person, so, you know what I mean? But anyway.
Right, so, you know, I am the babysitter.
Okay.
Yes.
The babysitter? Mm. Interesting.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, okay.
All right.
So you never able to a babysitter like me yet?
No.
I can't hold a baby back, Gordon. So I fit the profile, fit the position.
Okay, so I take it that you're the star of the
no,
play.
No, I never.
Aren't you the lead character?
I don't think so. No, the show is not centered around me. It is not. And persons need to understand that.
Are you the character Shebada in it?
Yes.
And you're babysitting.
Yes, but I'm not the star. And persons need to understand that. 10 years. It's 10 years now. I've never been given a show for myself, saying that, Shibi, you are the star. No, I've never.
To this day?
To this day, I've never, ever. Even
nobody
even Shebada come to town.
And are you?
I came on 45 minutes before intermission. 45 minutes, yeah. 15 minutes before intermission. Yeah. So, I've never given.
So all your roles are supporting roles?
Yes.
But now you dominate all of these. I mean, Bashment Granny is you.
I mean, because
isn't it?
Bashment Granny is very funny, too. Because my thing was to come in and out, in and out, in and out.
So you stole the show?
It was not my intention. I'm sorry. It was not my intention.
So, Chicksters.
Yes.
I get it right?
Chicksters, right.
Chicksters.
It's not. I'm not the lead character in Chicksters.
Yes.
I'm not.
So, who is?
You have Trudy, you have Suzette Barrett, you have... Tassie, and you have Caroline, you have Luke Ellington. Mm-hmm. But for Trevor and myself, we are supporting actors.
Trevor?
Yeah. We like it that way because it's a training ground for both of us.
Okay, then. Oh.
You don't get time to relax. So persons who like lead role and enough part and excitement, not me.
Okay.
It's a school for me every time I go on stage. It's a school.
So, Chicksters. Opens
Chicksters, December 16th at Mullins Road, 58 Mullins Road, right.
Oh.
Olympia Crown, Olympia Theatre.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's where it's opening mm-hmm. and will be for the rest
for
of the season.
For some time until we start going
so
on
the road. So it will be running throughout the season, right?
Yeah.
Well, sir, congrats on the 10. I hope it will be many, many more. And that you will someday be the lead act. In something, because
no,
I'm surprised that I think when I hear your name in these things, I just figure you are the top man.
No, because when you bless, you bless. You understand me?
Well, there you have him right here on stage, Shebada. Stay with us, still to come.
The first time you see ya, me see ya, me see ya.
The next Grammy Kid.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back from two local reality TV shows to recording artists. And now, nominees for the most coveted award in music. Dancehall artist Devin Di Dakta and singer JL have moved from the realms of talent show contestants to Grammy nominees in the Best Reggae Album category for their 2016 effort titled Reggae for Her, produced by Sly and Rock. Devin
JL are now the youngest persons to be nominated for the Reggae Grammy. A phenomenal feat given that their respective careers in music are younger than 3 years. Devin Di Dakta, right now, right here on our stage. Devin.
Di Dakta.
Congrats, sir. Lots of it.
Yeah.
Lots of congratulations. What's the feedback you're getting out there from fans, from the space, generally speaking?
Everybody seem proud so far. Mm-hmm. You know, you have like a naysayers and thing, but majority of the people who feel proud, I mean, we work real hard on this album. Mm-hmm. So, and me, myself also feel so proud of myself, JL, Sly and Robbie, cause the entire team.
Okay.
Yeah, so the excitement.
How did you react when you first heard the news?
Well, it was like the morning after my birthday. So it's my first day of being 21.
Oh,
so, yeah,
wow.
So it's the best 21. Birthday present
wow.
that I ever get. So it's like the night of my birthday, I went on the road. Mm-hmm. So the morning now, wake up late, say a bag of missed call from Shelly, that's my manager. Then after that, as me click on Instagram, me start see my picture all about, then me see Miss Kitty posted me and with the caption, she said, la, 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 la. So I'm reading there, so now if you see, if she got say happy belated birthday. But then when me say the first part about Grammy,
yes.
me just put on your phone and start jump up and down. The whole place smash up.
Okay, so you know that the album entered for, was submitted. Prior to that, to it being submitted, were you thinking Grammys when you were?
Always, from as we started the album.
Yeah?
Because we took time in from last year, about November, we started recording the songs. Because remember, we had a song on Sly and Robbie's album last year, that is Ayo Ayo, featuring me and JL. And then after that, the chemistry with me and JL, it was so real. You know, like, we enjoyed each other company, enjoyed working with Kaz, Sly and Robbie.
Yes.
So Kaz came up with the idea, say, why not just do an album? So from there to now, we got all the rhythms, and then we just took time to listen to the rhythm. Me come up with some of the ideas, bring it to the studio. We worked on it. JL likewise come up with some of the idea, took it to the studio. We all worked on it, and took a little time, and so all right, next year we released it. We did about 15 songs. And we chose the best 8.
So you have producer's credit too?
Mm-hmm.
You're part of the creative
entire
process,
thing, yeah.
The entire?
Yeah, man. And Kaz now, him decides a Grammy we go for. So 3/4 of the credit, I have to give Kaz. Kaz has a new man. Mm-hmm. But I have to give him a lot of the credit. And say, Devin, we go for the Grammy, you know? Because he's Japanese. See there? Grammy.
What do you anticipate, though, that this can do for you, or will do for you? Just the nomination.
This,
let's not talk about
the nomination,
winning.
Yeah. Yes. This, I mean, a lot of doors are open.
Already?
Already. Especially internationally.
Wow.
A lot of people, some may not even know some emails that may get. Mm. A lot of people say congratulations and can't wait for you to come to New York. We start doing some work in the studio and all sorts of things. So especially internationally.
Okay.
A lot of people are really commenting on it. Even some of my songs now that was released a good while ago, bad songs, you know. See people gone on it now, and like after reading the comment, some people commented that I'm here because of the Grammy nomination. I really love this guy and all of these things. So that does show good music was there, but like we really start get the real attention.
Okay, so they're now zeroing in on your catalog.
Yeah.
And they're liking what they're seeing?
They're like, yes, so far.
So where does that leave your dancehall street cred credentials?
No, dancehall is still in it, because when I listen to the album, you still go, can say, that me not really sing. I'm not really a singer.
Yes.
So I still have the root, the dancehall.
I know that. As it relates to the album, you're fine. You're a dancehall artist, and anybody can pick up your dancehall. But now that you're being called, because this is how it is, you know, you have Grammy credential.
Yeah.
How do you go forward with a nomination for a Grammy under your sleeves?
This show that I'm like the reggae side, the more roots, one drop side, that's the real music. That are the one where people really accept. Because even right now, I have one of the biggest songs in Zimbabwe, which is also a reggae one drop song.
Yes.
Produced by Robert Livingston and the Cole Art Rhythm. Several different countries in Africa. That does show that people accept me more for the reggae side. But still, dancehall, I can't let the dancehall people, and because the dancehall really put me out to the front, Magnum King and Queen. So I forgot to Magnum King and Queen, a Grammy show now. So.
But as a youngster, you're recognizing and acknowledging that musicianship and music being part of it with proper arrangement and taking time to do songs will pay off.
Pay off, yeah, man. I think an idea. I know what happened now are the best. Substance at the long run, substance ago, past hype.
Whole heap of things will be coming at you, and it's a learning curve for you. If nothing else, you will learn a lot. And hopefully, you can help to change some of your own, your compatriots, and your generation of both consumers, because consumers are more largely more important than artists, you know. If they're consuming more thoughtful, well-arranged songs, then people like you will do more to feed them.
Yeah, definitely.
So they are critical. But I also think that it will open up your consciousness and your listening and your consumption of some of the greats who have gone before you.
I've always listened three quarter if I check, like, even my iPod, my computer, three quarter of the songs I really listen to are reggae.
Yes.
Like, I grew up listening to reggae. My father, him have him bus and him like a sound system at night. I grew up and listen to, like, all Frankie Paul, Barry Sam, and them. That's like, even the album, all the songs are like songs for the ladies. So that like a love thing that's called Reggae for Her. Mm-hmm. But with the name now, it's Reggae for Her. In mind, we had it as Reggae for Her.
Yes.
So it got farer than the rest of reggae, so Reggae for Her.
But where was your career? Where would you say your career before this announcement?
It was still growing. I mean, we have some other songs, like, over in UK.
Okay.
On the BBC radio thing, you have the three number one. The three, you have 1, 2, 3, you have the Moscato rhythm, Kulu Kulu rhythm, the Skelewu rhythm. I was featured on all of those. Mm-hmm. Anybody who travel the Caribbean regular can tell us, say, you hear ribbon be ding ding everywhere. It's a must play in all of the clubs, all of the parties. So, I mean, it's just Jamaica, you know, you think more while. If you're not in the street every night, and them now see you every night in all of the parties, it's like you're not hot. But when I put Jamaica to the world when it comes to music, it's like, well, that's, you know, it's like a football and four football feel. You see me? So I never really pray that. I always pray so at the end of the day, you have people out there where I listen. And them know good music. So at the end of the day, good music are gonna last.
Absolutely. There are two roads. There's catalog and hot.
Yeah.
And the two don't always mix. So, you know, hot is one thing, and highly disposable, but there's catalog.
Yeah.
Catalog artist will always be here, no matter what. All right, so the case with Corey Todd did not at all derail your career.
No, not time.
Where is that case now?
That case still in court, January. In January, we have the case. We go back in court again, so.
What do you expect will happen? What do you want to happen?
I just want to get over with. I don't have time for that. I have Grammy to think about.
That's good. Good for you, of course. So are you...
That just done and passed.
So will you actually attend the Grammys?
Of course, yeah, man.
You're going? You're going to LA? You're going to the Staples Center?
Yeah, man. Visa, work, plan and everything, so.
Sin?
Yeah,
and you won't have any hurdles? You won't have a problem getting a visa?
No,
do you think?
Me not think so.
With a nomination and no bad record, you should get it.
Yeah, man, definitely.
Well, U.S. Embassy, give the kid a break, right?
Yeah, man.
All right, sir. Devin, it's so nice, sir, to have you here talking to you about this. And I hope you're inspiring. What I want to happen for this is for you to inspire other youngsters to look to achieve what you have achieved. Even a nomination is a big thing to have on here. Anything about Grammy is big for a youngster at 21. Congrats again.
Yeah.
All right, so that's our show for this week. Winfred Williams, on behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more On Stage. And always, so much more than entertainment. Whoa, baby girl, you look real good. I treat you like a real man should. Make we love you without reason. Girl, I love you out the season. It's like hey, oh, hey, oh.
Thanks for watching our video. If you are not yet a subscriber, click now and be on stage. Always.